Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. So today I'll be showing you how to accept input from the user. There are several ways to accept input from the user, but by far the most easiest way to accept input from the user is by using the scanner class. There are several methods in the scanner class which you can use in order to retrieve information from the user in the form of integer, double, string, boolean, long, short, or byte. But in order to make use of these methods to retrieve the information, we need to import the class first. We need to import a class, the scanner class, from a package called java.util. So I'll be doing that first. Right below this, import java.util.scanner. Now you can write the statements either in your main method or in the constructor of your class. Although you can write it in the main method, I prefer to write the statements in the constructor because it's a good practice. It's a good practice while programming in Java. So I'll just do that. So first things first, I need to create an instance of the class scanner. Just a spelling mistake here. Yes. Now I need to create an instance of the class scanner. So I'll be doing that. Scanner. I'll call the object input. So it is the input object is of type scanner. So new scanner C. Now what I've created here is an object of type scanner. The name of the object is input. Now the scanner accepts some specific type of parameters. It can accept a string parameter, or it can accept a file object, or it can accept input from the keyboard. For accepting input from the keyboard, you need to give a special parameter called system.in. So it accepts whatever information the user types on the keyboard. So it retrieves those information. Now let's say I want to get the price of a car. So the prices of goods will be in the form of decimal numbers. Enter the price of your Land Cruiser in thousands, let's say thousands, and semicolon, next line. Now in order to retrieve the information in the format we want, we need to use some methods of scanner. So we have already created an object of type scanner. The name of that object is input, so we'll be using that input now. So double price input dot next double. What does next double do? It retrieves the information from the keyboard or from the user in the format of double. So double is basically decimal digits, which are numbers which have a decimal point along with it. So it retrieves this info which accepts as long as decimal numbers. It always prints it as decimal numbers along with the decimal, but compared to double can accept an input which is both integers and decimal numbers. So basically it is a larger storage system for numbers. It stores numbers. So basically I'm getting the double double value from the user right now, and I'm saving it in the variable price. There are many methods like next. There is next. If you use only next, it'll return you a string. It'll retrieve the information from the keyboard in the form of a string. If you use next boolean, it'll retrieve the information from the keyboard in the form of a boolean value that is true or false. So there is next double, next boolean, next, next line, next int. There are several methods that you can use depending on the format in which you want to collect the information. So prices will always be in the form of decimal numbers. So I'm using next double. Doubles, it's a format of decimal numbers. So next thing, after retrieving the information from the keyboard in the format of double, I'll be printing the value just to show you guys that I've got the value. The price of the car is we'll be using formatted string or printf. The formatted string, this is the formatted string. So I'll be using %f. %f is a format specifier of double numbers. And price. And always don't forget to close your scanner object. If you don't close your scanner object, there'll be a resource leak. So you won't be able to use the scanner object in the next time. If you create a new scanner, you won't be able to use it unless you close the previous scanner. And also, it is not good practice to do it, because your resources are being utilized at that time. When your scanner is kept open, object of type scanner is kept open, the resources are being utilized. You need to stop the usage of those resources non-memory wise. So that's why we are closing the scanner object. It's very necessary. It's necessary and good practice to do that. Now, do you think this code will execute? What do you think? No, it won't execute, because as I mentioned in the previous videos, we need to create the new object in the main method. If the main method is empty, there won't be an execution. So you can see the main method was empty, but I'm now writing new first. So I'm actually creating an object. I'm just calling the constructor of the class, which is basically like creating the object of type first. So now what do you think? Will it execute? Yes, it will execute now, because the public static void main method is calling the constructor first, which is in turn creating the object first, which is in turn creating an object, but not assigning it to any variable. It's just creating an object, anonymous object. So now it'll execute. Enter the price of a Land Cruiser in thousands. Let's say an average Land Cruiser cost. The price of the car is 174. It's just printing as it is, thousands. So you don't actually need this thousands, it doesn't make much difference. I just wanted to show you guys that I can retrieve the information and display it. That's it. So as I've mentioned, the easiest way to do it is using the scanner class. The easiest way to accept input from the user is in the form of scanner classes. And that's what you'll be using in your object-oriented programming course.